All right, in this video, we're going to learn how to do architectural dimensioning on our guest cottage project. So the guest cottage project is the one that you completed in chapter 4. It should look like what you see on the screen here. So it should have the walls, the hatch in it, the windows, the doors, the notes that you need, closet up here with the rods and shelves. You should also have this little note down here, wall thickness 4 inches. Along with the window labels and everything. So what we're going to do now, you know how to dimension. We dimensioned in chapter 5, but that was mechanical dimensioning. So architectural dimensioning, the concepts in how to set it up in AutoCAD are the same as what you've already done in chapter 5, but the application of architectural dimensioning doesn't have the same rules and everything that you had in mechanical dimensioning. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at what you see in the book. So we're in chapter 6 here. We're going to create a new dimension style. We're going to call this ARC 48. We're going to start with standard. And with architectural dimensioning in particular, it's easier to start. Notice how we don't start on the lines tab right here. Let me zoom this in a little so you can see. We don't start on the lines tab. It's easier to just start at primary units and kind of work your way backwards, because until we set our units to architectural, then we can't go set up, fraction height scale, for example, because we aren't set to fractions yet. Until we set our symbols to architectural ticks, we can't extend beyond ticks in the lines tab. So it's easier to just kind of start backwards, work your way this way. So I'm just going to follow the pictures here and set it up just the way that we see it. So we're going to start a new dimension style. We're going to call it ARC 48, starting with standard. So I will come over here and let's see, annotation, several ways you can get to your dimension style. I can, on the home ribbon, I can pull this down and go to annotation, pull it down and you can see my dimension style here. I can come over to the annotate tab and I can click on that tiny arrow. Lots of ways you can get there. It all goes to the same place, but I'm going to create a new one. Looks just like the other screen. I'm going to call it ARC 48. Oops. There we go, ARC 48, continue. We're gonna click over here to primary units. We're gonna pull this down, set it to architectural, 1/16. We'll set this to not stacked. There's no fractions in this one, so this part isn't all that necessary, but we'll do it the way that the book shows it, not stacked. And we'll come over here and we are, for zero suppression, we're gonna suppress 0 feet, not 0 inches. So suppress 0 feet. So in other words, if something were like a 6-inch wall, it wouldn't say 0 feet, 6 inches. It would just say 6 inches. Be careful not to suppress the zeros over here. This is only on angular dimensions. So we're talking about linear dimensions here on the left side. So 0 feet, architectural, not stacked. Let's look over, oops, let's look over here and make sure architectural, 1/16, not stacked. And we're gonna suppress 0 feet. So that looks good. Let me move this off to the side. The next one that we're gonna do is, just the next one on the page, is symbols and arrows. So we'll click over here to symbols and arrows, bring this back. Let's check out what it says. Symbols and arrows, we're gonna set it to architectural tick, leave that at close filled. Arrow size 1/16, 1/16, pretty much everything straight down is going to be 1/16. We're not doing arcs and linear jogs and anything like that, so we're only looking at the left-hand side here. So we'll come over here, change this to architectural tick. Notice if you do it once, the other one automatically does it. It's defaulting to 3/16, so let's just do 1/16 here. We'll do 1/16 here. Break size 1/16, just across the board, we're doing 1/16. Set this to line and it's all set up. Like I said, we'll just kind of ignore what's on the right hand side here. We're only doing arrowheads, center marks, and dimension breaks. Now when I come over here, flip to the next page, now we're going to go to lines. Make sure everything is by block. Extend beyond ticks is 1/16, baseline spacing 3/8, and then over here 1/16, 1/16. So pretty straightforward. Everything's by block. Extend beyond ticks, 1/16. This is 3/8, and then this was 1/16. And then offset from origin was 1/16, and everything else was exactly the same. Come over here, Now we're going to the text tab. So standard, by block, text height is 1/16. Remember, text height and arrowhead size always going to match pretty much 1/16 for just about everything here. The difference is here, when we get to text placement, we're going to make sure that it says above, centered. This is 1/16. And then this is the biggie right here, aligned with dimension line. So whereas our mechanical dimensions were all horizontal, all the text stayed perfectly horizontal, this is going to be aligned with the dimension line. And the dimension text is going to be above the line. So we'll come over here. 1/16, looking good. 3/8, everything looks good. 1/16 across. I'm looking at the wrong one here. So standard, here we go. Text height is 1/16. We're going to change this to above. We're going to say 1/16 here. This is already centered, left to right. That's good. The key is we're going to click this one. Watch this text adjust itself. I'm going to say aligned with dimension line. And see how these side dimensions turn sideways. So you can read them from the bottom to the top. And then these, the horizontal ones are going to be read left to right. So that's the key here. We're going to leave this on standard, 1/16 above and aligned with dimension line. Last but not least is our fit tab. Let me move this over here. Whoops. There's our fit tab. And we're going to leave it at either text or arrows can go out beside the dimension line. Everything else is unchecked. The key here is we're going to scale these dimensions up 48 times. So that is what we call our dimension scale factor, DSF. We're going to come over here to the fit tab, above, beside, leave everything unchecked. The only change we really should make is 48. So basically what this is going to do is, if I look at my text, I told my text to be 1/16 of an inch. If I really had text 1/16 of an inch next to a 15-foot by 18-foot building, I wouldn't even be able to read the text, right? It's so tiny. But what it's going to do is scale that text up 48 times. So 48 times 1/16 of an inch, and that makes my text readable. The logic behind this is 48 inches, or I'm sorry, the drawing scale factor is 48. That means the if I were to plot this at 1/4 inch equals a foot, there are 48 quarter inches in a foot. So it takes my scale, my text, I scaled this thing down basically 48 times to get it to fit on the page. It's going to scale my text back up 48 times. So when I get ready to print, my text will actually print at 1/16 inch. Does that make sense? So that's my drawing scale factor. Set your text at the height you want it to print at. Figure out how small you scaled it down, and then scale it back up here so that it'll print the right size. That's it. That's all I got to do. I'm going to say OK here and close. Let's go ahead and set that one current and close, and that looks good. So that's setting up the dimension style. Next step, we're going to put the dimensions in the project itself.